expressly warned that you should repent and come to the Lord Jesus Christ. He is the Lamb that came into the world as a spotless lamb. He knew no sin. There was no guile in his mouth. He came and took the sinner's place. And what he did for you is what no one can else can do for you. The scripture says that greater love has no man than this, that a man should lay down his life for his friend. The Almighty God, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Creator of heaven and earth, entered the world. He's created as the Son of Man. You might have heard of some people saying, well, where is God? If you say Jesus is God, when Jesus was here in the world, who was taking care of heaven and earth? Well, my friend, I want to tell you that Jesus Christ is 100% God and 100% human being. And with God, there is nothing that is impossible. The Almighty God, entering into the world, is created as the Son of Man, born of a virgin Mary, of a virgin woman, a woman that has not known any man. He came into the world for the purpose of him becoming a propitiatory sacrifice, Passover lamb, that his blood, when sprinkled upon the sinner, and sinner willfully repent of their sins, are purged from their sin. My friend, there is only one thing that can take away sin. Your good work cannot take away your sin. My good work cannot take away my sin. The Bible says all our righteousness is nothing but as filthy rag before God. There is no kind of kindness you might show to your own fellow human being. There's nothing you can do, either in the kind of a charity, giving money to beggars, or trying to help people, the homeless, feel the poor, feel the homeless, clothe them. All these are worthy deals. They are good things to do. But I tell you, my friend, God considers such things as nothing but as a filthy rag. The scripture says that it's only one thing that God will look at a sinner. When he looks at you, you have to be clothed in the righteousness of his Son. The Bible says that, for without the shedding of the blood, there is no remission of sin. Jesus Christ came into the world in order to give you his own righteousness in exchange for your dirty linen, your own sinful nature. God wants exchanging if you will permit God to do that. And friend, that is what we are here to tell you. We love you. Someone who loves you will tell you the truth. If I don't love you, I will stand here to speak to you. I should be somewhere, maybe helping myself. But I'm here because of the love of God. Because God has shed his love abroad in our heart. He said, go and tell my other fellow creatures like you that I have saved you from religion. I can tell you a little bit about myself. Well, I was a religious guy. I was born into a religious family. And on Sundays, we go to church. And I was baptized when I was a little baby. And by sprinkling of the water. And after a while, I had the sacrament of confirmation with a name of a confirmation they call Peter, and I also had to take other ordinances like the sacraments, taking the Eucharist. I served Mass, I was in the church. I find myself, you know, being an altar boy, I served Mass. But my friend, I want to tell you, I had no peace. I got to confess my sins to a man who himself is a sinner. And at the end of my confessing my sins to him, he said, I absolve you and tell you to pray a number of prayers, maybe say the Lord's Prayer about 5 or 10 times. And say the Hail Mary 10 times. And you went away thinking that, oh, your sins have been forgiven. And I went on Sunday, I received the Holy Communion. But back on Monday, until Saturday, I'm back into my old self, committing various type of sins that is awful to confess publicly. Then on Saturday again, I will go to the Father, and I will kneel down and say, Father, forgive me, for I have sinned. I have done this a number of times. Please, I will not do it again. And the priest will say, I absolve you. And I will say the act of contrition, oh my God, forgive me, I will not do it again. And the cycle keep on repeating itself. And when I recall one of the day that I went to confess my sins, I was speaking to the priest. I said, priest, as a doctor, you are a spiritual GP. If you are treating a patient, you need to check the progress of your treatment. If is there any effect on the sickness? I say, I find myself that the sins that I have committed last week that I came to confess, I have repeated them, that I am disgusted that if God was to be me and I was to be God, I would not forgive. I would say, God, sorry, I'm not, I don't want to listen to you again. You are not serious. Well, the priest said to me that, that is why the priest is here, and you can confess your sins, and God understands that. Even if you break them again several times, it doesn't matter. So, well, that was the answer the priest gave to me. And I said to him, well, what happens if during the middle of the week I didn't have chance to come and confess my sin to you and I had an accident, and in the accident I was pronounced dead on the scene? The scripture says that the wages of sin is death. The gift of God is eternal life through His Son Jesus Christ. The gift of God is eternal life through His Son Jesus Christ. Therefore, if I have broken all those sins, I say I'm not going to, the sins I have committed last week, I break them again, and I didn't have the chance to come and confess them again to you, and I die in my sin, I'm going to hell. That's what the Word of God says. And I was shocked. So the priest doesn't have any solution because he's not born again. But I want to thank God for what happened to me. I went in the college. I went into a meeting organized by a Christian association known as the Fellowship of Christian Students. And I saw this young students in the college, and they were very happy, rejoicing and singing praises unto God. And I was startled and surprised the kind of joy that radiated from their face. And I wanted to have what they had. I knew I don't know have the peace of God in my life. I was just like, the scripture says that the sinner is like a troubled sea that cannot rest. Outwardly, it appeared I was okay, but inwardly I didn't know the turmoil is within. there is no peace for the wicked. The Bible says there is no peace for the wicked. If you don't know Jesus Christ, the Bible says you do not have true peace. And at the end of the fellowship, the students invited me for fellowship the next day in the hall that they were going to have an outside speaker coming to speak to them about the Lord Jesus Christ. I said to them, no, I'm not going to come because I have my own religion. I will go to the mass as a Catholic student. I have to wear my school uniform, and the school bus would have to take us to the town mass for us to go and have mass. So I said, no, if it is to be any other day, I will come. But unfortunately for me, I went back. I was confused, and God was dealing with my heart. He says that freedom from sin or continue to sin, make a choice. Freedom from sin, continue to sin, make a choice. I went to sleep. I couldn't sleep. I rose up very early in the morning. I dressed up. I wanted to go to the bus to enter and go to the town mass. But I found myself, I couldn't do that. Just went into the student hall of meeting. And I sat down there. And there were a large group of students. And I was just sitting at the back of the hall. And this man was preaching the word of God. And everything he said, it was just like an arrow that was drawn and shot and pierced through me, and I find myself weeping. I was crying. I knew that I was being convicted by the Holy Spirit of God. My sins, he took upon himself. God convicted me of my sins, and I cried to God. I said, what can I do? They said, you come out and just confess your sin directly to God. You don't need to go to any human being, either the priest to confess. You confess directly to God the Father, asking him to forgive you because of what Jesus Christ has done for me. And my friend, that is what happened. And I prayed. And at the end of the prayer, the joy of the Lord filled my heart. I was so excited, and I was rejoicing and dancing, and I want to hug everybody. I said, something has happened to me. God took away all the heavy load of sin. My friend, sin has a load, a weight it confides in you. The only one that can take them away is the Lord Jesus Christ. So today, if you want to repent, you can speak to any of us here. We have brethren here who is going to listen, who we want to hear with you and pray along with you. You confess your sin directly to God. None of us can save you. The only one that can save you is the Lord Jesus Christ. My friend, that is how I came to become born again. And to finally finish the story, I tried to be smart by hiding what has happened to me, the change, the transformation that has taken place within. The Bible says that if any man is in Christ Jesus, he is a new creature. Behold, all things have passed away and all things are new.